for bringing me to the aquarium, Arnold. But I don't get it. Why are we here?
The Nissan Elgrand. So you want to do a service on a Nissan Elgrand. What tools are required? What do you need to lift it up? Got my trusty jack from Super Cheap Auto. So I put my jack under there. I'm going to put some more support under there just for safety reasons. And then if you look under here, need a bit more light, but you should be able to see an opening, and there's the oil drain plug beside the front right hand tire. That's the one I want to go for. Pull that or the oil is going to come out. This is a setup of how it's looking underneath here. As you can see, you've got the jack there, jack stand beside it. I've got a tire here for safety. At the back, you can see a brick. You just can't ever be too safe. You never know, anything could happen. You think no earthquakes happened over here, but hey, you never know when the earthquake will come. Have many things for the car to fall onto other than yourself. There's the oil draining out. Might have to move my oil pan. So to complete this oil change, this is what you're gonna need. A nice ratchet, a 14 mil socket, preferably a slightly long one, because it's a bit deep in. And there's the oil sump plug right there. It's out, so it's currently draining. That's where you're gonna fill the oil later. If you can see that. Yeah, so those are the things you're gonna need in order to pull off a nice service on Nissan Elgrand. Just waiting for the last drips to come out underneath. Then we're ready to put the sump plug back in, fill it up with some new oil, and the service will be complete. Now, when putting back in the sump plug, it's just the reverse of how you took it out. You want to do it by hand first. So you put the bolt up there, you feel for the hole with your finger, and just start twisting. One thing you got to do is don't drop the washer that's on this bolt. Just loosely. Has to go in easy. Then when it's finger tight, grab your socket. Make sure it's sitting right. After that, plug it into your ratchet, set it to tight, feel for it under there, then start tightening. It doesn't require much force, just enough. And that's it. The oil was black and it was due for a change. Look at that, black. New oil looks like honey. This is black. Now, make sure everything you put underneath the car is out of the car, okay? You've moved it away from the car. We got the tire over there, got the jack stand here, got the oil pan out of the way, and then lower it. Because if you don't do that, you might damage something under there. So you stick it on this part of the jack stand. It's like a switch. Once you put it there, give it a bit of a twist to the left. Slowly starts coming out. Don't fully twist it, as you want to control it. A controlled drop. There we go. It's out of the way. We'll load the car. Now to fill the oil. So to fill up the elgrand's oil, there's a bit of a groove here, as you can see. Shove the funnel in that groove like that. Bring the oil up and start pouring. See that color? It's like honey. That's how it should always look. And when it's not looking like that color, you know your oil is old, and it's better you change it. The more you change it, the longer your engine will last. All the little debris go. You know, have clean oil. It's not that hard to do. It's fun, you know. It's fun to work on your cars sometimes. If you can see here, you got the low mark and the high mark for the oil. See those lines? Make sure your oil is always up here. Okay? So if it's not up there, just top it up. You know, you don't have to do a full oil change and drain it and everything. Just top it up at least, and then when you have a chance, if the oil is starting to look dirty, that's when it's time to drain. Or you can follow the service manual, and it'll tell you every 10,000 Ks or whatever. Follow the recommended change intervals. I mean, for some of us that have sports cars, we probably change it more often than that. But cars like this, you know, I don't know if the last owner changed the oil lately, but it was very black. So I've changed it. Now I'm going to make sure the oil is up to that mark. I'm thinking it might be close. This is a 4.6 liter oil capacity car. And I only had 4 liters of oil, so I might have to go get another small bottle of oil to make it full. But just remember, there's always a little bit of oil left over. So even though, you know, it says 4.6 liter capacity, it doesn't mean you add 4.6 liters of oil, because there's always a little bit left if you haven't fully drained it. Like, I haven't changed my oil filter, so I know there's probably some oil in that too. So we're just gonna stick the dipstick in, check what the level is. Might be a little bit left to go, but at least you can see where it's supposed to be. If it's not up to that mark fully, I'm gonna get some more motor oil, and I'm gonna top it up some more. So down here, you can see the dipstick, where it goes. Slot it in there. It usually takes two hands because it's very flexible. Once you put it in, you know, it's been sitting for about 5 minutes, this car, so the oil's had a chance to settle in there. I'm gonna pull it back out, put it here, and see where we're up to. See, the oil is up. So we can see we've got a full amount of oil in there. You know, it's gonna be a little bit mixed with some black oil because, you know, we didn't change the filter and all that stuff, and there's always a bit of oil left over. But that's why you drain it, you can flush it out, change it again, and it's gonna be full golden in there.